Hello, my dear students. Good evening. And today we are going to learn about the poem, "The World is Too Much with Us." The world is too much with us. This poem is written by William Wordsworth. First of all, we discuss about the poet's achievements, his personal life here. William Wordsworth was born in 1770 and died in 1850. 1770 and 1850. He is one of the major English poets. He is a nature poet par excellence. William Wordsworth is called the poet of nature. The poet of nature. In as much as his poetry deals with not only the sights and the sounds of the nature, but also a beneficent influence on man. So William Blake is called the poet of nature because he loves the beauty of nature. The beauty, the nature has gifted us so many things. So he loves that nature, and that's why he's called the poet of nature. And you know that basically William Wordsworth is known for his work famous for lyrical ballads. Lyrical ballads. It was published in 1798, and it is co-joined work. It is co-joined work. Work with S.T. Coleridge. S.T. Coleridge. And it is called the Romantic Revival. Romantic Revival. Revival. Among the various characteristics of Romanticism may be mentioned the love of nature. So, love of nature is one of the major characteristics of Romantic age. Love of nature. According to the experts, one of the major characteristics of Romantic revival is nothing but love of nature. And obviously, William Wordsworth is called the Romantic poet because he loves the nature, he worships the nature. And an interest in what is remote from everyday reality. Basically, we can see that in his poems, he presents the reality of life. Reality of life. William Wordsworth presents in his poems the reality of life. And an intensely personal mood. Wordsworth's lyrical muse was more reflective or passionate. Hence, Wordsworth found the sonnet the most poignant vehicle of expression. He is the most notable writer of sonnets after Shakespeare and John Milton. So, William Wordsworth is a notable poet after William Shakespeare and John Milton. William Shakespeare and John Milton and third one William Wordsworth. So William Wordsworth is a major contributor of romantic age, and as well as is called the poet of nature. The best known poems of Wordsworth are his Prelude. So here the major works of William Wordsworth, the Prelude, the Daffodils, Ode to Immortality, and The World Is Too Much With Us. These are his major works, and the present sonnet expresses Wordsworth's dissatisfaction with the growing materialism of his day. So this poem is a sonnet poem. Sonnet means a poem. A 14 lines poem is called sonnets in English language. So sonnet is nothing but a 14 lines poem. So sonnets are actually in two parts. First part includes 8 lines, and second part includes 6 lines. So sonnet is nothing but a poem of 14 lines. First part includes 8 lines, the second one includes 6 lines. So in the present poem, William Wordsworth laments the dissatisfaction about his days. So here, you know that he hates the material world. So, and that's why he laments and he is dissatisfied with his age. The poet's laments man's folly in turning away from nature. He actually laments about the folly things, the foolishness of man in his time, and basically he laments because a man is away from the nature and he loves the nature. A little do we see in the nature that's ours, and in being wholly taken up in the business of getting and spending. He uses the stress getting and spending, rather than be a materialistic Christian. He would prefer being a divinities, and is quite at home in the world. The poet says we have little time for the beauteous forms of nature, such as rolling waters. So many things are there. The nature has gifted us so many things, like rolling water, then the landscape and the quiet sky. The landscape and the quiet sky. Hedge rose. The bare sea, the pastoral farms, Nature leads us from joy to joy. She has found to feed, inform, instruct, and impress upon us. Wordsworth gave a call to go to nature. He said, "Nature is the best teacher." According to William Wordsworth, nature is the best teacher. So here we have discussed about the personal life of William Wordsworth, his achievements, his major works like The Prelude, The Daffodils, Ode to Immortality, The World is Too Much with Us, and he is third one, William Shakespeare, John Milton, and William Wordsworth. These are the major English poets of Romantic age, and The World is Too Much with Us is nothing but a sonnet. A sonnet is nothing but a 14 lines poem. First part includes 8 lines, and the second part includes 6 lines. And basically, William Wordsworth is known for his best work, co-joined work with S.T. Coleridge, Lyrical Ballads, and which was published in 1798. And in the present poem, he laments about the materialistic world of his day and dissatisfaction of that age. And most importantly, in the present poem, he explains about the rolling water, the landscape and the quiet sky, hedgerows, the bare sea, the pastoral farms. So many phrases he has used in his poem, getting and spreading like this. So here we have discussed about his personal life. In the next video, we are going to learn about the poem and its explanation. Thank you for watching the video.